Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to insert or add a list of tables into your Word document. So here I just got an example document with lots of example tables in. If you want this view, then just go to View and then just click on Multiple Pages. And then you'll have most of your document on one page. If you've got lots of pages, go down to the Zoom button at the bottom here or the Zoom slider, and you can zoom in and out to access more pages if you want to. So in order to add your list of tables, you need to have a caption below each table, and then Word will recognize it and put it into a formatted list. So at the bottom of each table, I'm going to go to the bottom of this table and just place my cursor here. You can make a space if you want to, or you can just leave it where it is. Then go up to References and go to this icon here that says Insert Caption, click. Now, at the moment, it already says Table 1, but what you might find is it's actually on Figure 1. So in order to get the table, just go to the label, click on the drop down, and go to Table. You can go down to Numbering Format if you want to and click on that. You don't have to go for 1, 2, 3, etc. You've also got other options here as well. You can also include a chapter number by clicking on this box here, and then you can start with whichever heading you've chosen. But of course, you need to use the styles or the heading styles in order to use this section here. Then just click OK. Once you're happy, just click OK. Then after this table one, you can then type in your description. So I'm just going to put sample table in here, and then you can continue down to the next one. Now, if you want to customize this text, just select it, go up to the Home tab, and just customize that text as you normally would using this section here. So you can increase the size using this option, you can make it bold, you can take off the italics if you want to. It's completely up to you. Once you've done that, you can go down to the next table, go back to References, go back to Insert Caption, and it automatically goes to table number 2. Because it knows you've already used up table number 1. Once you're happy again, just click OK, and the same thing will happen here. And then you just put in your caption. If you want the same formatting as this line here, select it, go to Home, click on this paintbrush tool here, and then just simply click and drag across this text, and it will automatically change it to exactly the same formatting you used for this one here. So I'm going to add all of the titles for the rest of the tables, speed up the video, and then come back and show you how to insert the list. Okay, so once you've finished labeling all of your tables, all you need to do is go down to the section where you'd like to add your list. I'm just going to press the return key and go to page 4. And if I zoom out, can actually get 4, there we go, 4 pages in one view. So I'm going to add my list of contents at the top here. I'm just going to take that italics off there, and I'm just going to add the title. Then just press the return key, and then I want to put in my list here, so click on References, and then I'm going to go to this icon here that says Insert Table of Figures. So this will bring you to this dialog box here, and the first thing is the caption and the label, and you can use any of these, but obviously we've just got table, that's what we've chosen. You can also use from templates, but you can click through these and figure out one that's more suitable if you want to. I'm just going to click from template, and that's going to list it as you see here. This is your preview. And then you're given the option to include various elements. You can check or uncheck these boxes to suit your needs. You can also go to modify. This will give you the option to modify the paragraph. So let's go to modify again. And here you can change how the list will appear. Now, by default, generally, you've just got a single space. I'm going to go for a double space or 1.5 spacing here. You can make it bold, italics, underline it. You can change the font size if you want to. And also you can change the font as well. So let's go for this font here. Then once you're happy with everything, just click OK, OK again, and then click OK once more. So here you can see that table has appeared. But let's say, for example, we move this section to the next page. As you can see, currently table 7 is on page 3. Table 7 is on page 3. So if we just knock this table down to page 4, just move the whole section down, you can see it hasn't updated. So all you need to do is double click anywhere on this list, right click, go to update field, and then click on update entire table, and then click OK. And you can see now that table 7 has updated to page number 4. So that's how you insert all of your captions and then how you insert your list of tables. You can go back and change any of this. So let's say on table 7, I change this to example table instead of sample. Again, double click down here, right click, update field, update entire table, and click OK. And you can see again that title there has been changed in accordance with the changes that I made up here. If you want to change the look of this, then just select it all, go to the Home tab, you can reduce the font size, you can take the bold off or put bold on, you can change the font again up here if it doesn't quite suit, and you can really play around with that table. It doesn't affect how it works, so again, if I was to double click here and right click, you've still got this option to update the field. So it hasn't changed how the table will work, it's just changed the overall aesthetics. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.